Hello everyone, in this video lecture we'll see how to solve the divide and conquer problems using Master's theorem and other method to solve divide and conquer recurrence equations using substitution method. So these are the main two methods we are following here, and regarding the substitution method we have already seen how to solve that, and now we'll see how to solve the recurrence equation using Master's theorem. The complexity of many divide and conquer algorithm is given by recurrences of the form T of n equal to T of 1 if n equal to 1, A T of n by B plus F of n where n greater than 1, where A and B are known constants, and we assume T of n is known and n is a power of B. So remember, this equation, so second equation, is very important. So whenever a problem is given, you represent in this second equation form and try to apply it. So n has to be a power of b. If f of n belongs to theta of n to the power d, where d greater than 0. So now this f of n portion you have to represent in terms of theta of n power d so that you can obtain the d value. Now if this is the basis, then time complexity will be T of n equal to theta of n to the power d if a less than b to the power d, theta of n to the power d log n if a equal to b to the power d, and theta of n to the power log a to the base b if a greater than b to the power d. So first you represent the equation in this form, a t of n by b of plus f of n, and then represent in this one of these cases if based on a and b to the power d value. Now let's solve the example. We have an equation T of n equal to 2 T of n by 2 plus 1. So now let's relate this equation with the Master's theorem recurrence equation. So that is A T of n by b plus F of n. So what is A here? A is 2 and B is 2. B is 2, and this portion always gives you f of n, and that you have to represent in terms of theta of n to the power d. So n to the power 1 here we have, so that can be represented as n to the power 0. So d is 0. That's how we got d value. Now let's relate a and b to the power d value. A is 2, b to the power d is 1. So a is greater than b to the power d. So since a is greater than b to the power d, so the third case we have to apply to get the time complexity. Third case, t of n will be theta of n to the power log a to the base b. Log a to the base b will be log a is 2, b is 2, so n to the power log 2 base 2, so log 2 base 2 is 1, so it is theta of n.